Remember to click subscribe and notification button for more APA's video.
Cooking APA.
Hi, this is Cooking APA. APA is going to make curry chicken, Malaysian APA style. Okay, so I have about, this is probably about 1.2 kg of free-range chicken, chopped to big chunks, yeah, and marinated with a little bit of salt. Some people will also put in some curry powder, up to you, no problem. There's no rules in APA's kitchen. What else you are going to put? We are going to put some potato, yeah, cut into chunks, but make sure after you cut, after you peel off the skin of the potato, put the potato inside the water. If not, it will oxidize very quickly. And you can choose to pan fry your potato first. Today, APA is lazy, so APA is not going to do that. Then I'm going to add some fuchuk strips. Yeah, this is fuchuk strips and rehydrated, soaked under water. Some people hasn't seen fuchuk strip inside curry chicken before, but my mother used to do it when I was small. So what else? I'm going to put few chunks of big chunks of tomato also towards the end. And let's look at how to make the curry paste. Very simple actually. We have approximately 2 tablespoons of chopped shallot, 2 tablespoons of chopped garlic, 1 tablespoon of chopped ginger, 2 tablespoons of chopped fresh coriander, and 1 piece of lemongrass. Bruise, yeah, you want to knock on, bruise it, yeah, bruise your lemongrass. And then these are the curry, mixed curry powder. So I have, basically you can even ignore this, yeah, the orange color. These three here is the main three powders that combine together and become curry powder. This is 2 tablespoons of red chili powder, 1 tablespoon of turmeric powder, 1 tablespoon of coriander powder. So the ratio is 2-1-1. So these three itself will give you what we call curry powder. And this thing here is actually 1 extra tablespoonful of Baba's meat curry powders, just optional. And you will need some chopped tomato. This is about 1/2 piece of chopped tomato. 2 more things we haven't shown just now. This is curry leaves, and this is coconut milk. I'm actually using coconut cream. You can use whatever you have, right? Right, let's start cooking. Give it some oil. You're going to use quite a bit of oil here because later your curry powders is going to soak up all the oil. We're going to saute the fresh herbs. Going to saute this for a minute or two, we will come back shortly. So this is after a minute plus sauteing, we are going to put in the chopped tomato. If you put in your tomato together with the garlic and ginger just now, then your garlic and ginger will not be as fragrant anymore. So we are ready to put in the powders. Now I'm going to turn the heat to the lowest because all the powder can get burned very, very easily. And you will see immediately all the oil will be soaked out by the powders. And if you find it's too dry, you can actually add some oil. Yeah? It should be a paste. I'm going to use low medium heat. So we are going to slowly saute this curry paste for a couple of minutes. At least 5 minutes, I would say, to really bring out a nice fragrance. You want to cook the curry paste, but you don't want to burn it. So use medium low heat. We will come back 5 minutes later. So this is after about 5 minutes, you start to see the oil started to break. Yeah, meaning you can see the edges, the oil has coming up. It's telling you the curry paste is almost there. You can now actually put in the chicken together with the potato. Now you can turn back on medium high heat and mix everything nicely together. Can be a bit choking right now, yeah? Right. Now we can actually add in some hot water. Plus some diluted coconut milk. Why you want to dilute the coconut milk? Because if you cook the coconut milk, a very thickened coconut milk, the oil may break, yeah? So just dilute it, that it won't break. Go for medium high heat right now. Immediately it's so beautiful. We still have one more thing, which is the fuzhou, yeah? My fuzhou, after softened, rehydrated, we still need to cook it for minimum 20 minutes in order for it to be edible. So I'm going to put it now. And we have some curry leaves. Put it now. Oh, we have some really nice, beautiful color. I'm going to add in a bit more hot water. I like my curry chicken to be really have very strong coconut milk flavor. So we are just going to bring this to a boil, and I'm going to give some basic seasoning first with some salt and sugar. We can still adjust to taste towards the end. I'm using free-range chicken today, so the curry is going to taste so good. Right, after it is boiled, I will close it with a lid and tune down to medium to medium low and let it simmer for minimum 20 to 25 minutes. Alright, so this is after about 22 to 23 minutes under medium low heat simmering. I just opened the lid and added the tomato inside, yeah, the tomato chunk. So basically it's done. Just want to make sure the potato is fully cooked, yeah? And we want to do some final seasoning as well. Nice. Just want to give it a bit more salt. Just now we already added it some, yeah? Yep. About another teaspoon. And if you prefer even more creamier, you can add in some thickened coconut milk right now. I'll be adding some. You probably need to add a bit more salt later after the coconut milk. You can now off the fire. Wow, super fragrant. Just make sure the salt is enough. That's all. It's basically done. Super fragrant. Okay, I have garnished a few pieces of curry leaves on top. Yep. So there you go. This is Appa's. Very flavorful, and to be frank, I think this is one of my best curry chicken. So if you like my video, do share my video out on your Facebook to your friends. Come to Cooking Appa Facebook fan page to click like and follow button. Follow Appa on Instagram and subscribe to Cooking Appa YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Bye bye.